Hello friends, and welcome you all. You are on my channel Monday Mornings with Mansi. So today we are going to speak on the topic of tongue thrusting habit. What exactly is this habit? It is nothing but placement of your tongue in between the two teeth and the lower lip. And this habit is usually followed when you are swallowing or when talking. So it is nothing but something like this. So, when your tongue pushes your teeth forward when eating or drinking or talking, so during all these activities, if your tongue is being pushed, it is called as tongue thrusting. So, Mansi, tell us what exactly is the normal position of the tongue? It is right behind your upper front teeth, right on the palate. So, that is the normal position of your tongue. Hey! Hello, I am Dr. Mansi Shaha, your oral health consultant. And if you are new to this channel, please subscribe here. And this is my show Monday Mornings with Mansi. And you can also follow me on Thursdays where I present some Hindi shows especially for you. And so coming back to the topic, tongue thrusting habit. So what exactly are the reasons for this tongue thrusting habit? So the first and the most important reason I could list is the retained infantile swallow. Mansi, what is this big name? So the retained infantile swallow is nothing but when the swallow of the baby is retained more than 6 months is called as retained infantile swallow. That is when a baby is sucking milk from the mother's breast or from the bottle, he places his tongue in between the two jaws or between the gums. So when the teeth erupt and when you stop breastfeeding, that is the period when the habit starts changing. If this habit does prolong, if this habit does stay long, then it is called as retained infantile swallow. So by the 6 months of age, this habit should go. The second reason is a prolonged bottle feeding. If you are giving your child more of bottle feeding, then also this habit does prevail. The third reason is associated with other habits like thumb sucking habit, nail biting habit, mouth breathing habit. All such habits can be associated and related to tongue thrusting habit. If you have not watched my videos on these habits, which are very much important, then you should just visit that videos and watch them. I am sharing the link here on the screen and also in the comment section below. Please do watch my other videos too. Okay, coming to the other reasons, it can be upper respiratory tract infection, like infection in the nose or passage of your air. Then it can be hereditary also. It can also depend on the neurological disorders, like if there are sensory or motor loss of your tongue. Then it can also depend on the tongue size. Yes, you have heard it right. The tongue size also matters. If you have a bigger tongue size, then also you can have this habit. Okay, so keep watching this video because I'm going to shortly tell you the remedies. But first let me tell you the clinical features. What can exactly be the changes or the facial changes associated with this habit? So the first and the most important facial change is an open bite. What exactly is this? That is, the lip remain open. The patient or the child is not able to close his lips or seal the lips. Then why does this happen? Because as you know, the tongue is pushing the teeth in the forward direction. So normally if the teeth are like this, because of the tongue, they are just being pushed forward. Because of the forward placement of the teeth, the lips are not able to close. Then there are major changes seen in the lower jaw and in the upper jaw. Jaw is nothing but jabda in Hindi. So the lower jaw, this jaw is normally in coordination with your facial profile. It has to be behind your upper thing. But if it is too much behind, then it is because of the displacement of the tongue lower. So your tongue is pushing your jaw below and it is stopping from it to grow. So it is backwardly placed. You can see the profile how it is in the picture besides me. Then the upper maxillary jaw, that is the upper jaw, In that, it is constricted. That is, the U-shaped jaw, the full-fledged U-shaped jaw changes to a V-shaped jaw. So, the profile changes drastically. You can see it in the picture here. Now, also because of all these things, there is an obvious thing that it is changing the facial profile and there is increase in the facial height of the person. So, all this is are associated with the facial changes. So, a child or the patient having this habit are not able to pronounce the sounds of this following letters. S, N, D, T, L, T, H or TH. So, all these letters can cause mispronunciation or difficulty in the speech. So, I am going to tell you how to cure this habit right now, right here. So, moving us towards our treatment for this habit is treatment number one. 4S exercise. So what exactly is this 4S exercise? It is nothing but training your tongue to swallow correctly and to be in the right position. So let me tell you what are these 4S. It is spot, squeeze, salivate and swallow. So what are you exactly supposed to do? Your tongue is to be placed right behind your upper front two teeth. This teeth right behind it, you have to place your tongue. Now, with the tongue, you will spot that location. Then squeeze. With the jaw, you'll push it up and squeeze that area tightly. After you do that, you will automatically salivate and then you will swallow the saliva. Let me just show you. So it is. Yes. So, you have understood this 4S exercise. You have to do almost 25 to 30 repetitions of this exercise. So, the next second exercise is going to be fun and your children are definitely going to enjoy it. Take a sugarless candy or a fruit drop or an elastic rubber band. Place it on the tip of your tongue and tell your child or the patient to press it harder against the palate. But this exercise has to be done under the supervision because the elastic rubber band or the candy can just choke up the respiratory tract. So just be aware and be careful while performing this exercise. But yeah, it is going to definitely train your tongue to be in the right position. Even for this, two to three times daily you have to practice this. And this they can practice when they are studying or watching television. So you will distract them from actually doing that exercise and they will unconsciously train their mind to follow this new position of the tongue. Then the next is training the other muscles around the tongue so that the tongue can rest and be free to rest in the correct position. So next is yawning, gargling, counting from 60 to 69. This counting can of 60 to 69 will help them to improve their speech. For improving speech, they can also read newspapers or some storybooks loudly. This will help them to correct their speech. Yeah, why yawning and gargling? Because the extra oral facial muscles, if they are trained and if they fall in the right position, they will help the tongue to be placed in the right position. Okay, so here is the end of the treatments and if even by this exercise the habit is not corrected, you know where to go. Yes, you have to visit the dentist. The dentist is the right person whom you have to visit and get the appliance for correcting this habit. I'm showing you the appliance right here. The appliance, as you can see, has some barrier kind of thing, which prevents the tongue from thrusting in the forward direction and it trains the tongue to be placed in the right direction. And what are the beneficial things of this appliance? It helps you to correct the malocclusion created, that is the change in the position of the teeth that has been created or the facial changes that has occurred. All these things are covered up in this appliance and can be corrected by this appliance. Hopefully, I am able to solve all your doubts and clear the doubts about the habits. If there is anything else related to this habit or any other habit or specifically any oral health concern, then please ping me in the comment section below. Do not forget to subscribe this channel and watch me on every Monday and Thursday for the good oral health. Stay healthy, stay happy, and be aware of it.